Okay. Let me make sure I have my stuff set up correctly, really quick. So, sound in my ears, mic, blue headphone. Okay. Just making sure I got all this right. I think I need to change the thing on here. It doesn't look warm enough. There we go. Okay, where am I going? Because let's look at this journal. Okay, so I've been almost everywhere. Where am I currently? I don't know. We need to go. Okay. We need to go to that place in the bottom right, and then we need to explore this forest. And we should be done. And then once we do that, we can go to the thing. If you know what I'm. You know what I'm saying? Okay, hold on. So I was looking at day zero. Okay, so I need to find Tide and Day Zero. Let me clean my glasses and then we're gonna be on our way. Oof. Okay. So let's find out where we are. Because I haven't played this game in about, it's been about a month since I played. I need like a map station. It's gonna tell me. Okay, here we go. This will tell me where I'm at. So, let's see. Okay. Oh wow, so I'm like nowhere near where I need to be. So I need to go all the way down until I cross the river. Okay. Because I am nowhere near where I want to go. Did I already click on that car? I don't know if I did. Oh? You hear distant music. Distant sound of someone running towards the phone, knocking things over. They pick up the
Oh,
phone.
thank God someone is still down there. I've been trying to get a hold of someone for hours. Oh, thank you. I forgot the Day Zero materials. You know, the visual literature, the warm bath of ideas? I left it at the dig site. It should be sitting on a barrel with a fruit sticker on it. Oh, wait! Hold on. I forgot to do the secret password. I don't even know who you are. Is it too late now, you think? Okay. What day is the day after tomorrow? Phew! Okay. I did figure you'd be... Sorry, I didn't recognize your voice. Hard to keep track of all the new recruits.
Oh yeah, I'm a new recruit, you just don't know.
What else was I gonna say? There was vandalism on a few of the posters. Bad stuff. I put them in the trash. Keep an eye out for more. Anyways, thanks for answering. The Day Zero material is in the dig site, pretty sure. It should be sitting on a barrel that has a fruit sticker on it. You know, I guess I was going to say you could bring it to me, but the flood will destroy it anyway. So, actually, I was worried for nothing. Everything is lost in a flood. God, we really know what we're doing. I'm excited for this all to be over. I'm excited for this all to begin. Bye-bye now.
That's suspicious. It's almost like he's excited for the flood, which I don't like to hear. Okay, let me look at this. Okay, where am I now? Okay, so I went the wrong way. Yeah, for Pete's sake. Okay, hold on. Okay, so I need to go this way. I was thinking about recording the sound of the phone as it was ringing, but I was afraid if I didn't answer the phone fast enough, like, I wouldn't get to hear, like, who was on the other end, so I was like, oh, let me answer this, like, super fast. Here we go. We can cut through here. Okay. Girl. Where am I? Oh, here we go. Okay, let's leave this back here. And then, okay, so where are we now? Okay, so we're right here. So we just need to go a bit further down on the grass until we reach a bridge on a river. Is it down that way? I think it's down this way. I hope it's down this way. Yeah. This has to be it. None of this looks familiar, so I think this will all be new from here on out. This is good. I don't know why I want to take a picture of this broken tree. Thank you. Okay, so we're almost where we need to be. Let's have a seat and relax. Sketch. This is gonna be a good sketch. I can already tell. Period. I love it. I love the art in this game. I feel like it's like not too much, but still has that like artistic viewpoint that a non-artist like just doesn't have, you know? And I really enjoy that. I can appreciate art, but I can't make it, and that's okay. Is that a noise that I can record? Again. I mean, what was that? Like butterflies? Okay, who lives here? What do we got? Over here. Nothing? Okay. Let's take a picture of your house because you have a cute house and I like it.
This house has such a palpable personality.
I'm gonna turn up my sound just a little bit. Oh wow, look at all this clutter. Holy cow. I didn't even see all this. Okay, hold on.
I'm not sure what to think about this.
Oh, I thought she was singing. That's why I started humming too. Is it like a... I don't know what it is either, honestly. Couldn't tell ya. This is junk. This is a junkyard.
What a cheap looking contraption.
Is that a stove?
I'm not sure what to think about this.
I think it's a portable stove. Tonight, Manchez performs Songs of the Prismatic Grounds. Sold out.
Too bad this is sold out. And happened 100 years ago.
So we're late. We're hella late.
This instrument is so beat up, but lovingly preserved. It must have played some important tunes.
Is that a crystal violin? Let's see if I can just turn up the sound really quick. Oh, that's the size of a bell, okay.
This instrument is so beat up, but lovingly preserved.
BRB.
It must have played some important tunes.
Okay, sorry. I needed to turn off my heater. It looks like a crystal violin, but I could be wrong. I just love the noises in this game. I think it's definitely like an ASMR based game, I feel like.
I hope this isn't the face of a god.
It probably
it
is.
It looks like he'd steal your lunch.
It's probably Tide. Or Din. Oh wow, look at that. What a pretty house. What is this? Oh. Oh, hi.
Oh, that sound.
What?
The camera click.
You don't like it?
The valley used to be so full of the sounds you couldn't hear yourself think.
Probably because of tourists.
Now to hear it again. That sweet, awful click. You came to see the work of the reclusive artist. Come here. Let me see. Bring it close. My eyes. I can only see here.
Okay, I'll bring it to you. I'm gonna take a picture of you really quick, though. Hold on, we gotta take a few more pictures. I wonder if she made all this. Hi. Oh, you're so adorable. I like her vibe.
The text is barely legible.
What's the text?
Three aphorisms from the young. None should see the face of love and live. Just one more to complete the set.
Interesting. Wait, what is it saying again? Three aphorisms from the young. None should see the face of love and live. What does that mean? It sounds very profound. She's probably gonna put it in her journal somewhere. You know how much Polaroid film you would need to take all of these photos that she's taken? Like, she has lots of Polaroid film. I was going to show her a photo that I took. Here, I'll show you. This is the one that I took when you asked me about it. So, I mean, I'll show you that one, I guess. What do you think?
What was the point of these creatures?
Those were living things.
The horned dogs of war. I look at them and I feel nothing. A crazy woman made this junk. An artist.
Oh, I thought she made this stuff.
I buried her a long time ago.
Dang, okay.
I'm surrounded by it.
Oh.
I spent my life trying to make something beautiful and true. I failed.
Aw.
Can you bring me photos of my art?
Sure. I already took like 10.
I'd like to see my work one more time. I want to see how I wasted my life.
Aw. Wait, so did she make this art or not? She just said that she buried the woman who made the art. Does she mean that, like, she buried an old version of her? Or she buried the actual person? But I don't know. Look at this. What do you think?
The figure is without grace or true emotion. I thought if I stood outside his door long enough in the rain, that God would let me inside. All I did was toil my fingers to pieces. I wanted to capture this valley in a piece of art. That's all. But when is the moment? Is it now? Or is it now? Enough about my... Let me see what else you've got in that journal.
Have a look.
My trash all on a page together, like a real art exhibit. One day, you could add my name to it. Mitsuyora. They might as well know who to blame. A museum vault. Every artist dreams of their work hanging on its walls. Oh my God. You'll try to go there? It's so far. It'll drain your life away trying to reach it.
Yeah, it's good to have a long-term goal, I think.
It might be a longer term than you expect. You may be as old as I am by the time you get there. Your journal might end up in the vault, which means my artwork might end up there. Oh, that would redeem everything. Every wasted hour. When a dream crawls back out of your throat, it hurts. But I can do better than those little statues. I can, if you help me. This art will memorialize Cheng Valley, and we'll finish it together. Cheng Valley has many faces, many themes, characters, eras, stages of its existence. Take a look through this junk, and we'll pick one of those faces. A face to show Cheng Valley to the unborn children of the next season. You do that while I make some tea.
Okay. So she basically did something to make an exhibit of everything she has. That's what I was already doing. So, hold on, just give me a moment. So I already have quite a few photos.
There is no end and no beginning.
I like that. There is no end and no beginning.
You seem lost. We are here to choose a theme for our artwork. You can see through the clutter. I have looked at all this for far too long to see it. There are no mistakes, only wayward inspiration. Just pick the face, facet of Cheng Valley that calls out to you.
Okay. This violin is giving.
This instrument is so beat up, but lovingly preserved. It must have played some important tunes.
Oh, you've brought me Manchez's violin. He was a wonderful singer. We were so proud he came from Cheng Valley. He collected stories, games, and songs and spread them across the world. You remind me of him. He had the most beautiful smile. That is what the world is missing now. Charisma. Oh, he had it. One look from him would bring you into the conspiracy we call life. The feeling in the air when he sang, the energy, like anything could happen as long as it was beautiful. Do you want this to be our theme? Very good. And the tea is ready. In the past, I tried to control everything. My work was dead. This time, let's follow our intuition, gather some pieces, and see what happens. What magic might be hiding in this day, which will pass and never return? This tea is good for the throat. It makes me want to sing.
Chubale mi hu sanota. Chubale ni hu sabe. Chubale ni hu sanota. Krimo sanahi. Pleminu tu sakanora.
That was it. That was Ching Valley. I thought we would capture Ching Valley in a piece of art, but we captured it in a moment instead. A moment can never hang on the wall of a museum, but you will still carry it with you. You were the co-author of this moment. I would never have found it without you. I'll rest these weary knees, these old eyes. But you're welcome to bring me images of this valley. As long as you bring them close enough for me to see, I'll tell you what I know. There's only a little bit of today left. And then the city, the flood, the lights, the next season.
Artist assistant. How cute. Okay, I have quite a lot to put in this journal. Okay, let's... let's do the violin. This was her house. So we're gonna put that there. We have a picture of her too.
A face worn with the strain of creation. She is compelled to create, like how I feel compelled to document this season.
Chubale mi hu sanota. Chubale ni hu sabe.
Her voice is a lot sweeter than her voice, which is interesting. Like, her singing voice is a lot sweeter than... I think her singing voice is different than her voice actor. I could be wrong though. Okay, so now where do we go? Okay, so that's filled in now. So now we need to go back and we need to get to. Okay, there's another temple up there. So I think we need. It's a circular area. Okay. I know where we need to go. Unstuck. What does that mean?
Night has fallen. The doors to the shrine must be open now.
I'm not ready to go back to the shrine. I got some stuff I need to explore. Okay, wait. So we need to turn around, sadly. But first, let me take a picture of this. This is actually really cute. Yeah, I like that. Okay, anyways. Sorry, I'm trying to get the right lighting from this camera. I mean, from this LED thing. That's too, like, yellow, I feel like. Oh, gosh. See, that's too bright. Yeah, that's way too bright. Hold on. It's also too bright. That kind of works. Okay. That works for me. I don't know if that's too bright. Nah. See, but that feels too dark. Like, am I not crazy? I mean, I think I'm not crazy, is what I'm saying. Okay, we're just gonna do this. And if it's too bright, then it's too bright. I don't care. Okay, so we need to go towards. Okay, wait. This is, like, low-key confusing. Because. Okay, so we need to go that way, right? Oh, wait, no. We need to go up here. Wait. Yes. Aha. Let's go up here. Please keep the soldiers asleep forever. I'm praying for a dreamless sleep. I want to wake up new and not carry the arms and limbs of dead memories into the morning. Please let me rest. I hear the electricity in the air. I hear the radio waves. I hear cars moving on a distant highway. Please let me rest. I like the second one. Dreamless sleep. Yeah, let's keep that.
Those sleeps are prayers to this god for sleep.
So is this the god of sleep? What is that noise that I'm hearing? Oh, it's over there, I see. Okay, let's take a picture of this really quick.
Oh, I prayed to see you again. I didn't expect it would be in a dream. Life listens and then it does what it wants. We have to make do, darling. I've been thinking about how much the season needs you, and how the season after that will need you desperately. I wish I could help, but this is a brief dream. What can we say?
I forgot my name. Should we tell her that? Maybe she can tell us our name.
Oh, you lost your name. It took a while for your dad and I to agree on what to call you. The name we ended up picking was my idea. If you lost your name, why don't you use the name your dad wanted to call you by?
Oh?
He would have called you Maria.
Oh, wow.
I don't know if you will, but I know I will see you again. For so long, I'll think it'll never happen. I'll almost make peace with having lost you to the world. But then, oh. But then, all the work of my grief undone in a moment, and I saw you again. Oh, I wept, and I laughed. Someday, you'll have a child of your own. Someday, he'll want to see the village where his mom was born, and I'll be here, waiting for him. We'll stand together, just like this. I have a million questions for him, and he'll have a million questions for me. But before we can say a word, I'll look into his eyes. And I'll see you looking back at me. Take care, my darling. It's time to wake up now.
This god put me to sleep. I got to talk to my mom.
That's crazy. I feel like this god is the most, like, kind. All the other gods, like, took, like, the other god took my name from me. Like, that's awful. This god actually did something for me. Oh, I know what photos I need to take. Okay, hold on. We need...
Purple minerals are built into this statue, too.
Okay, and then I need to take one more picture. It has to be at the bottom of the cliff. Or a hill, I guess. Okay, let's take a picture of it from right here.
There is something calm and descending about this statue. Like falling slowly.
Okay, that should be all the pictures that we need.
Sleep is the shadow life that connects us all. It gives a cycle to our days. A reset, a reflection, remembering and forgetting at the same time.
Okay, my screen is like super bright right now. Okay, so we have Tide filled out now. Okay. So where do we need to go now? Because I think that... Okay, so we're done, or we should be done. Let me make sure that we're done. All my pages, just kidding. Day zero. Okay, channel 63.2. I need to find a radio and I need to play the reel. Okay, hold on. Oh, for Pete's sake. Okay, retrieve bicycle. Yeah, give me that one. Miss Morgan. She was a really good teacher. She was so happy. Sometimes I'm... I don't know how to play that reel I found. I think I need to go back. Hold on. High key loss. Okay, so we're here. Okay, so to play that thing, I have to go all the way back. Well, I have to go back over there anyways, because I need to go to the temple. So we'll just go back there. But which way is it? Is it that way? No, I think it's... Wait. If we're... Okay, I'm lost again. I'm, like, actually lost again. Okay, wait. So we're there, right? Okay, we don't want to go to the bridge. We don't want to go up. We want to go left. Okay. I see. So we're going to get on this thing. And we're going to go this way. This is where we need to go. If this is not where we need to go, then I'm going to be low-key annoyed. Okay, yeah, we're going the right way. Clicked on these cards. There's a real player over here somewhere. Here it is. Day zero. Day zero film final cut. Should be shown within 24 hours of exposure. I'm scared. Oh.
We begin in our mother's arms. We open our eyes, but she's not there. We breathe in. Where is she? She is everywhere. And we breathe out. Good morning. Welcome. Congratulations. You have just stepped into a new season. You may feel as if you're seeing the world for the first time. You may have noticed that colors are more vibrant. You may have noticed that food tastes better. What you are feeling right now is how it feels to be liberated from the past. There once was a season that was beautiful, but everyone you met, their eyes were clouded, and their necks were turned backwards. They were weighed down by loss, haunted by the nightmares of another era. Now you may feel as if a great weight has been lifted. In certain cases, you may feel an unexpendable well of energy rising up inside you, because you know there is so much to do, that the world is ours, and it can be anything we want. With your help, we're gonna do it right this time. You won't be alone. There will always be a hand and a voice beside you. There will always be a song to sing.
Tear down the ruin in your mind, the wound you kept inside, can you let it go? Share now the season in your eyes, the people that you'll find will forget what's yours and mine in the world to come.
What if, on the other side of all our fears, is a better world? Or a worse one? What if it depends on what we do right now?
Damn. I don't know why that made me, like, sad. Okay, channel 63.2. I need a radio. Where do I find a radio? I know there's a radio on the farm. Maybe we can go to the farm? Where is the farm? Aha! I think there's a radio over here. Okay. I'm so confused. Oh. Do the cows like the music? Oh, music for cows. Okay, that's nice. I need to change the channel to 63.2. Can I? Okay, we'll just turn that off. And then we'll leave it. I need a radio. Like a... Oh, dang, y'all all here. My bad. Y'all must have really liked that music. Okay. I don't know where to find a thing to play channel 63.2. I'm thinking maybe the dig site. To be honest, it's probably not that important. I say we just move on and go to the shrine. Because I feel like the shrine is the end of the game. I know it's sad to say, but I'm kind of like ready to be done. So, let's get to the end. Okay, so where exactly is the farm in relation to... Okay, so farm is here. Okay, so we need to go back and then go up towards the temple. I think it's this way. Temples up this way. Oh, we're here.
I knew once I went into the shrine, my time to explore the valley was over.
Yeah, let's go to the shrine. I've like literally found almost everything. The only thing I did not find was channel 63.2.
In the heart of the shrine, the void sits alone.
Why? Oh, I did not see that man sleeping over there.
Who are you? What are you doing here? Hope this isn't your first day on the job. There isn't much season left to record. What's that? Around your neck. That's a pendant. You're wearing a pendant. My God, I've read about those. A pendant, a burner, 5 memories, 1 for each sense. What did you make the pendant with? And who lost the memories, you or her? I see. And what was something you burned? You burned a creature and a memory. Interesting ritual. Similar to what we do here, but different. Yeah. Why do I? Your mind will make it into the next season intact. You're protected by 5 senses, 5 lost memories. What about everyone else? Ever think about that? Why would you? Well, I don't need one. I'll be right here until the flood takes me. The first days of a new season are just so damn hopeful. Feeling that kind of hope again would kill me. I'd rather drown.
Wow, that's sad.
Of course, of course. Few things are as painful. I told you I read about them. Look at you, protected. The rest of the world is not so lucky. Me, the people you've met on your way here, nobody else is protected. You think everyone makes it into a new season intact? Tell that to the boys face down in the parking lot. You know things are about to change. I can tell. A collective pendant to protect a group instead of one person. You're welcome to try. My memories are all over the shrine. You can have them, destroy them, whatever you want. Asking an old monk to invent a new ritual. Let me die in peace. That fruit is an acquired taste, but go ahead, taste it for your... What did you call it? Collective pendant?
Oh.
Do you like the taste?
Looks like a pomegranate.
It takes time. Ah. Something about stealing fruit, being young, stealing fruit, something like that. Is that enough of a memory? I guess I won't forget it now. I'll forget it when the flood comes.
I have this doll.
That old doll. What is that? Touch?
Yeah,
everybody
I have the same
had that doll. A tourist left that behind. A little kid. I don't know why I kept it. I knew they'd never come back. But the life the kid imagined into this piece of fabric, I can still feel it. Who was that child? Why is this doll here? Sometimes I try to imagine them, and I see myself. Memory flows. It can even run uphill. To play this at breakfast. The woman who took care of me would cook, and I'd dance around. When I was older, I'd cook, and she'd sit and try to sway to the beat. She had trouble moving in her old age, but I can hear her foot tapping.
musicians are gone. The thousands of hours they spent learning their instruments are gone. The song plays on. It has wheels, but it looks like a house.
I remember seeing lights like these in the forest one night. It was Manchez, the famous singer. The only time I ever got to see him sing, but my eyes were on the crowd, seeing their faces in electric light, the joy of it. I grew up in a time when we thought our lives could be connected by electricity. How could we hate each other when we all love the same person? The brief, beautiful delusion that the world was knitting itself together. He dies, the war starts. Our season ends. Did I tell you already? Hope is the most painful thing in the world.
Wow.
Took care of me, taught me to pray with this incense burning. I wanted to learn, but when we kneeled down together, her being so close to me and the smell, I couldn't focus. She'd get angry, but I'd just get more lost. I asked her, which direction is God facing? She said, every direction. I said, so can I pray to change the past? And she said, of course. We change the past every time we remember it. I was so happy in that moment to have been found by her. I could have been found by anybody, or by nobody. That's five. Five memories. Five senses.
My name is Ezel. I was the last monk of Tiang Valley. I never finished my exams to be a monk, but I'm the only one left.
I took becoming a monk for granted because I grew up around them. If you're including a ruin like me, you must be serious about recording this season. What will you write about me? That's true. But I was once a scared little boy. I was orphaned by the war. The monks found me on the coast, wandering alone, shell-shocked. Sonia, the head monk, took care of me. I saw things I shouldn't have. She helped me erase those memories. If I had any memories of my family, I lost them too. But at least I didn't wake up screaming anymore. I was so afraid of accidentally calling her mom. She was the head monk, even before she ended the war. Sonia was an imposing figure. I slept, I forgot, and I grew. The soldiers came to the valley. Sonia hated the war for taking my family, like it took so many others. The most powerful prayers are always made out of desperation. She figured out how to amplify our sleep prayer, a prayer that could end a season. No one had ever done anything like that. She sent me to the coast to turn on the light posts, to signal that the season would end soon. I used to go to the light posts alone, just to dream about another season, to dream about being born in another season, to die in another season, to imagine a life where I wasn't afraid to have hope. I'd like you to have one of these photos, to carry it with you to wherever you're going.
I like Sonia. She was pretty.
Really? Why? She was, to me. They've shut off the power. Won't be long now. Imagine the waves rolling in here. The water is so deep that light won't reach us. I should pray one last time. We should both pray right now. Your pendant, the sacrifice your mother made to keep you safe. It might be possible to pass on this blessing, to divide its power among the people you've met on your journey, to shepherd them into the next season. For a truly strong player, we would need to use up the power of your pendant. I'm not sure it would work. It's never been done before. But I know it would weaken your pendant. In that case, nobody would be protected. Before you light the candle, I want you to think hard about if you want to do this. Do you want to pass on this blessing and leave yourself vulnerable? Or will you continue your role as a vessel of memory?
Wow, that's a hard choice. I say we use our pendant for the prayer.
I can feel the memory, senses, and energy in the air. I have not prayed with any great purpose in so long. Let's set our minds to it. Pray with me. Sink these words into the fragile earth to accompany lost souls. Listen to the record of our lives spinning and the old woman tapping her foot to the music. Taste the fruit we stole from the orchard and pretend to love the taste until you truly do. Heal the fabric of a lost doll. Smell the incense of an old evening sun. The caretaker prayer, the scent of the woods and the wedding tree. Turn your eyes to the colored lights. The faces in the crowd are the faces of your children. We offer this prayer on behalf of our companions. Let them find themselves with senses warm and ready for the life of the season to come. You have the sounds of the moment. The moment is already past. We've done all we can. I need to take you out of this place. It can't end here. Let's go.
The true end of the Tiang Valley was not the flood coming. It was when these people would go their separate ways. At the last possible moment, I saw them as a community. Without the protection of my pendant, I felt even closer to them. Whatever happens, we're all in it together. The Greyhand arrived. he had what he called passports for everyone. He said they were supposed to have a photo, but that his camera was broken and he wanted to use mine. I saw in these little papers the beginning of a new world. He asked me if I could help him. I had only one moment to decide. I said, yes. The Grey Hand thanked me. He gave me a pin and told me their new name would be Floral Path. Said he felt like driving all night.
Listen closely. The road behind you leads to the coast. There's an old warning system on the beach. An emergency light that can be seen from the other side of the ocean. You can warn the rest of the world about the change of season. All you have to do is turn it on. It was built to survive anything. I'm sure it still works. Do you understand? Of course.
Easel lives.
I've been thinking about that all night. I have this idea to turn my van into a shrine. For every sermon I preach, I'll listen to 10. And you will remember everything. You will survive everything. Rest transparent in the spirit that gives you rise. Farewell.
Wow, this is beautiful.
The warning lights look bigger than an easel's photo. Elder told me she grew up on a watery republic. The ship was commandeered during the war.
Wait, can I go down there? Oh no, I can't, sorry. Thought I could go down there for a second. Oh, I am going down there. Okay, here we come.
This is a life ring. I like the sound of that. Life of all birds is an affair between sky and... not sure where I was going with this.
Wow. We're walking on the side of a ship right now.
Her motto is very much in line with what I've learned about the golden season.
What does it say? It is possible to have a good time. That's good. I would hope it's possible. Get our bike. It wouldn't let me retrieve it, so I guess we're walking. Who is this? I have no idea why I'm recording him snoring.
My dad snored real loud, with a kind of pride about it, somehow. One time it was so bad, Mom made him sleep in the plaza.
Hello.
Hi.
Hello, yo.
What?
Ice cream.
He doesn't know English.
Good. Ha! What this do? Turn them on? Aha! I think wrong. It's not for sport. My village. I draw the life. You see?
You?
Safe village. Show.
I'll show him the statue.
Statue?
Yeah.
We have statue for war.
It's weird. No, I have weird. Public lizard for everyone. Oh! I say I live home. My mother no cry goodbye.
Your mother?
Ah, strong mom. Morning, Eily. I go far, far? Alone. Long time. Are you leave home? Ah. Good. Amazed I kill Abe, I'm a mola. As Noste Camila ek ohak. Nestelef ohak, I must ask. Who I'll tell ek and ek at me.
He's just giving me a whole story. He's telling me all about it.
Ak eli ek ohak. Ah, I ebernach el olahan on alol ek en ek etelen etelna.
Okay.
Look at crab now.
Oh, okay.
I see. I like it. I draw. What do you like?
Monkeys, owls, cows. I like the cows. They're really cute.
Sound. You play sound. You play sound.
Favorite sound to play? Wow, that's a hard choice. You know, I really like the sound of that frog from the beginning of the game, I'm not gonna lie.
This is a frog. A small being with an echoing voice.
Good. Here? 3 days together. Friend now. Sad that I go.
It's glitched. We're gonna ignore that.
Now, here, together, we are safe.
old monk surrounded by his memories. Is this a shrine to a god? Or is it a shrine to his past? On the beach, I move through the wreckage of an old season, and a way to warn the world about the arrival of the next. The cycle will continue. I hope I played my role well.
Well, I can't see anything. Oh, here we go.
The lights sent out a warning to the other side of the world. I wondered if anyone was watching. I wondered if anyone remembers what it means. This season is over. My new friend is sailing home in the morning. I've decided to go with him. I feel so scared and so relieved at the same time. I can't think straight. Before sailing into the unknown, I checked in on my journal, my letter to the future.
Okay, I'm gonna read all this out loud because this is very prolific for me. So, here we go. Who are you? I don't know, but I'm writing to you anyway. Where are you? How far in the future? Where do you find my journal? I may never know, but you could know me from what I put down on these pages. I come from a little village in the mountains. No one has left here since before I was born. But our lives changed overnight. Just a few days ago, my best friend had a prophetic dream. A vision that the elder said means this season is going to end soon. The world is about to enter a new era. A great change is coming. Everyone was afraid. I was surrounded by questions, and I began to feel how little I know. What is this season that is about to end, and why is it ending? What exactly is out there that could turn the world inside out? If there are still voices singing and laughing in the wilderness, I could record them before they're gone. I also thought of my dad, who always wanted to see the outside world, but never did. So I asked if I could leave. The elder had one condition for letting me go, that I take what I collect to the museum vault, a palace of art and memory at the edge of the earth. She says it's the only place safe from the turmoil of a changing season. I hope that's where you're reading this now. I can't stop the change that is coming, but this time on earth could live on in these pages, what it looks like, sounds like, how it feels to be alive right now. I'm writing to you at the crack of dawn on the morning I leave home. I can smell breakfast cooking in the other room, and I can hear my mom's voice. I just performed a ritual with my mom. The moment has passed, but I'll record it in these pages for you, for the future. My mother's lost memories protect my mind from diseases of the outside world. Caro Village. My village was created to survive the turning of seasons, but I don't want to just survive. I want to know life and carry it into the future. Who was Dr. Fumio? Dr. Fumio brought peace to so many people here. He cured maladies of the mind. He said the dream sickness was caused by something especially powerful. It was never cured. The path out of Karo. There's only one path out of Karo. These sights and sounds were so close to me all this time. I just needed to step out. The long journey. The past took me out into the open for the first time, into a world that goes and goes. The Elder. She was born on a ship part of the Watery Republics, pleasure boats with a radical political program. My grandparents played with the past. Tiang Valley Entrance. I came upon the entrance to the valley, hints of what might be awaiting me down there. What are the Grey Hands doing? Serene Pond Area. The valley was itself radiant with life. The air smelled sweet and green. Assembly Point. My map calls this place the Assembly Point. People passed through here not long ago. Cow Farm. The smell of dry hay. The ringing of cowbells. I try to understand animal-human coexistence. Shrine Path. Approach to the shrine. Ancient ephemera. Little quiescent quotidian ceremonies. Who is the tide? Who is the din? Who is the void? Parking lot. The cars are gone, but the land made cold and dead for them survives. What happened during the war? Cemetery path. The paths around the cemetery held signs of life. East Forest path. The land curves. We curve with it, and are curved by it in turn. Along the way, I hear and smell and touch and listen. Pate's dream. Cemetery. To remember the dead, they place a stone. To remember the stones, I take a photograph. Fruit farm. A farm upon a hill. What love and labor was expanded here. A life on the lawn. Sofa needs to finish packing by tonight. She can't decide what to take with her. I tried to help. Dig site. Tucked away in the West Forest is an area that has been recently disturbed. Kochi's tour. Sofan's son, Kochi, took me on a sightseeing tour of the valley. Ancient tree. This tree is the oldest, largest living thing I've ever seen. What is the dig site for? What is day zero? West Forest Path. I could feel the past flowing through the air here. I inhaled history, exhaled history. It's all too much. An artist in the valley. Deep within the forest stood a lone house. It belonged to an old woman who has been making art in the valley for all her life. She wanted me to bring her pictures of her work to see it one last time. The Shrine of Tieng, a secluded shrine nestled in the hills of the valley. A toast to Tieng. The true end of Tieng Valley was not the flood coming, but was when these people would go their separate ways. At the last moment, I saw them as a community. Without the protection of my pendant, I felt even closer to them. Whatever happens, we're all in it together. She already read all that stuff out loud, so I'll just skip that. The seaside. Isil gave me a ride to the coast. I'm starting to feel truly far from home. Wow. Oh, wow. Well, that's crazy. I think my pendant wasn't strong enough. Because I used some of it. Oh?
Blinding light. And a strange pattern disappeared off the surface of the water. My mind emptied out. But then my senses came alive. I smelled the ocean air. Felt the boat rocking, heard the waves rolling, saw someone else was with me. I detected the world for the first time. I was overwhelmed by its beauty and a feeling of possibility. Then I found this journal and I read carefully through each page. It says, "Here is my home. My mom, my friends. I didn't recognize any of them. And the loss hit me. I became aware of a massive absence. And I realized that if it wasn't for this journal, I wouldn't even know I lost anything at all. These pages are a little bridge between us and the world that just disappeared. And I put them together. So that must be who I am. Someone who left their home to take measure of the world before it changed. Here's a record of the people I met along the way, moments from their lives at the end of this era. It seems to have been a season where our minds wandered through memories and dreams of the past. I'll continue taking measure of the world, even if I never make it to a palace of art and memory. No matter where you're reading this, I offer you my journal and the lives inside it. If anything in here escapes from the page into the world, let it be one sentence. Just a few words you heard from a traveler on a bicycle. When at the end of the evening, she turned to you and said, "It is not too late."
How to leave home for my daughter. Find a sacred square of earth. Lay down.
Oh, wow.
So you have the dirt at your back.
Oh, wow. So this is it?
Close your eyes. Close everything. Do you see for yourself? You see for the dead, for the unborn. Do you listen for yourself? You listen for the dead, for the unborn. Your ancestors are in that dirt. All the living and all the dead are holding you up. Now, stand. They're still there, aren't they? It's time to move. To entangle yourself everywhere with everyone. So the next time you lay down in the dirt, you will have so much more to tell them.
Wow. So she was rereading her journal that she made in the past. That's crazy. So I'm assuming she wouldn't have lost any of her memories if we wouldn't have used her pendant to make the pendant for everyone. But we weakened her pendant. Wow. That was a good game. Give it like an 8 out of 10. Yeah, I'd say an 8 out of 10. It was pretty good, honestly. I liked it. I have to pee. I wonder if there's anything after these credits. Net ease. Wow. Well, I guess thanks for watching, and that was my playthrough of season. I hope you enjoyed it.
Peace out.
Actually, yes, peace out. I have to end this stream before I start a new one. I'm gonna come back and play Hogwarts, but anyways, thanks for watching. Love you all.